Hi guys, welcome to KDrama Club. Today we're watching My Demon, episode 13. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Guys, do not skip the intro, and someone take a screenshot of your phone or you guys watching. I love it. Tag me on your Instagram stories. It's really cool to see like you guys enjoying yourselves and posting that online. It's awesome. And I pick one and I share it to my story as well. So yeah, your chance to get featured. You're gonna get that side story of Madame Ju, finally. So weird to hear that. Imagine you're the wife. That's green flag. Caring for him, caring for his past self, giving him a little hug. Such green flag. No. Oh, I thought he was gonna give her the cross necklace. Fireflies are actually an endangered species in Korea. It's pretty native to Korea as well. We had fireflies for the longest time because they frequently appear in folk tales from like hundreds and hundreds of years ago. So we know we had fireflies for a long time. Yeah, fireflies are one of those species that only can thrive in really, let's say, uninvaded spaces. Like, the better nature you have in your country, the more better place for the fireflies to live. So, if you destroy your country, just, you know, environmentally, no more fireflies. And Korea did a lot in Korea, a lot of new buildings and yada yada yada. But yeah, we still have a lot of nature left, so we have some fireflies left, but they are still considered a endangered species in Korea. Ah, doggy. Hey, the little doll thing is still there. Nice. Most modern young people are not able to eat homemade food. Where is that? Soybean stew, some kimchi. A weird looking cup. Some mackerel, quail eggs. Dang it, they didn't show the whole food. Oh, I love the eerie Christmas carol effect. Sound design is always very good. Once again, in Korea, it's not 911, it's 119. That's why I said 119 on top, next to the ambulance. More ads. Oh. That's actually very common. Seok-hoon still uses formal language to Kwon. Kwon still is an asshole. I think she's okay now. To look at that picture. Love and War was a series in Korea where like divorce, cheating and everything was crazy. I think they are getting better at calling each other first name, but still haven't. Still, Dodoi, Jeongguwon. Guwon just said, 우리 도희? But, I don't know, that still doesn't really count. He's gotta be like, 도희야. Like, he's gotta like, lay that down. Ah, such a horrible person. Oh no. When he said that it's your turn, he was speaking in a informal way, and he called his mom like 당신, which is a way to say you, but like they're not even related anymore. Like a stranger. Dang, freaking OP boyfriend or husband. Which is plenty. Oh. Too much sweetness. I'm gonna get diabetes from this. PDA is something you just don't do in Korea, especially in workplaces. They both speak formally now, still. Oh. It's not easy making Korean food for lunch, honestly. You gotta wake up like hours early. That's not really a difficulty in Korea though, because you can just call a quick delivery service. They'll pick that up and send it to them. Oh, 다정 means kindness. And also, when Kwon said "Shining Solo," that's a callback from Jennie's Blackpink Jennie's song "Solo." So he just said, like, you want me to be a shuttle? Shuttle? Shuttle is a term that's used in like high school when you bully a kid into making them do stuff for you. We call them shuttles. Not really a good thing, but little bully reference there. I think she's crying. It's actually road of roses. I don't know why they said bed. So when they say gokkil, a road of roses, that means in Korean culture that you have a very comfortable road in front of you with no hardship. The book says how to make my child into a CEO. They look so happy. Oh my god, they're Lone Turks. So Yangji just means a place of yang. Umji means place of yin, like yin and yang. So like place of dark and place of, you know, light. So basically what Kuon said was stop working at a place of the darkness, work in a place of like light, which means, you know, stop messing around and like actually get a good job. Oh, he came all the way here to deliver, though. She's gonna pounce at him again. She really looks like my aunt. It's really weird. He's gonna say something like Tuesday or something. You're supposed to do that, and yes, all guys should do that always. They don't have a housemaid anymore? But seriously, no, not a single bad actor or actress in this K-drama. I haven't seen a single cringy acting. Oh, someone's gonna get some punishment again. That's a very good brand, though, for makeup. He speaks so softly when there's people. Yes, let's go, Sokun. Really? He's that dumb? She just asked for it? He actually just said, "I hope you don't make a wrong mistake." Chicken and beer in Korea is a perfect, perfect combo. He cut him off. Can they go against him if they all combine their shares, maybe? Abraxas, egg symbolizing the world. You have to destroy your world to be born. Oh, damn, though he's so smart. Oh, now she knows you did it. Are you gonna admit it? He is. Come on, we gotta know more. We gotta know what happened. So he didn't say ticket, he actually said a rope, because in Korean folktale, a rope can be descended from the heavens to catch you to salvation. But ticket works pretty well in this translation. That recording doesn't prove anything. Let's go. Let's go. No! Ah, these writers know exactly when to cut. Exactly when to cut. Ah. They showed us all the happy things to run the runtime to cut us off right here. Ah! God dang it. Oh, Suan's gonna be pissed off too. All right. Any questions? That was the worst cliffhanger or the best cliffhanger of the whole series, but we gotta wait. So he made the deal with Chu that the parents, we don't know, we gotta see. No, he made the deal with the parents first, because last episode we saw him holding the scroll, the contract, and then it disappeared. So unless that was a red herring, he did make it with the parents first. Question, I thought that Madam Ju was in her office scolding her son. She was saying that he killed Toy's parents, am I wrong? They didn't say who he killed. They just said he killed someone, so we don't know. What's up with the neck pillows at work? Do people really use those at work offices in Korea? Yes. Your neck gets stiff sometimes. You need some cushioning. Can you tell more about those folk stories about afterlife? Afterlife, there's not a lot of folktale on afterlife. It's usually religious, like Buddhism afterlife, which is reincarnation, which I think they kind of dip into in My Demon, because people reincarnate, they put everything in it, they just like mix everything, like Catholic, Buddhism, Korean, like old gods, weird. Are cakes, flowers, awards super important in South Korea? Cakes are there to celebrate something, just like any country. Flowers are, you know, how they use with couples. Awards, I guess they're important. The more awards you have, the more, I guess, recognition you get. And recognition is very important. Kenji, have you ever considered doing some older dramas? I get recommendations, I pick 4, let you guys vote, doesn't matter which era it's from. I guess I forgot the Kuon and Madam Ju didn't technically meet during the show before her death for some reason in my head. I thought they did. So what did he do to Seok-kun business wise? Oh, he cut off his workforce. So basically, he turned a lot of full-time people into part-time people, which, in Seok-kun's words, was murder. Is past life a big deal in Korean culture? Reincarnation, is it a big deal? No, not really. It's just something that we joke around with. Like, if you have a friend who likes getting drunk all the time and always sleeps on the street, you might joke that maybe he was a dog in the past life, like something like that. How do you pronounce Che? It's not Choi, it's Che. Let's see, maybe offered her a deal and she said no, that's why they died. Maybe, we don't know. Wait, he cut the cousin off from the company? Not cut off, cut him off to the company, but you know. He was trying to take him out of the CEO position of that department of the company. Because he is chairman, so he might have that power. Why do Kuon and Doi still call each other by their full names? Because they're not there yet. It takes time to drop formalities and get into the first name basis. Their situation is really weird, but you know, it does take time. Got a little lost regarding Abraxas and Do Sung-min. What was the connection? Abraxas was the code name that Do Sung-min used in order to tell the quote-unquote executioner, the killer, to kill everyone. Are loan shark gangs big in Korea? Not that big, but it's a thing. And anyways, thank you guys for watching. And I will see you guys on episode 14.